Hello everyone, welcome to part 81 of SQL for Beginner series. In this video session, I am going to explain how to use delimiters while creating the stored procedures. So in this video session, I am going to explain how to use delimiters while creating the stored procedures. The main topic is the main topic delimiters or is the main topic stored procedures? The main topic here is delimiters, guys, not stored procedures. I am going to explain how to use delimiters with stored procedures. Okay, how to use delimiters with stored procedures, I am going to explain. And also at same time, the stored procedures are related to PL SQL. Okay, they belong to PL SQL. What is PL SQL? PL SQL is an extension of SQL. Okay, after SQL, people go for PL SQL. If you are a developer, okay, if you are a developer, and SQL will have only single statements. Okay, single commands or statement kind of statements will be there, right? Queries will be there. Single query statements are nothing but SQL. Select star from employee. Okay, and insert into table values like that. Those are the SQL statements. But coming to PL SQL. PL SQL is nothing but the full form is programming language in SQL. Using this SQL statements, we are going to write programs. Okay, we have to write some programs, okay? Some logic we have to write. Like, what will be the general programming languages? For example, if you take Java, okay, Java is a programming language. What will be the basic thing? Variables will be there. Okay, then literals will be there. How to create the variables, how to assign this literals to this variable. Literals means values. Okay, then we have what you call selection statements will be there, like if condition and all those stuff. Okay, if else, if switch case, like that. Control flow statements will be there. They are like while loop, do while loop, for loop. Okay, all those things. Then lot of other concepts like functions, constructors. Okay, this all generally belong to a programming language, Java. Similarly, in case of SQL, we have a programming. Okay, if we have to do some programming with SQL, we cannot use Java, guys. Okay, I cannot use Java for programming the SQL. So what I have to do, there is a dedicated language, okay, which can use the SQL query statements inside this programming. Okay, such kind of language is nothing but PL SQL. It has its own syntax. Like Java has its own way of creating the variables, assigning the literals to the variables, creating all these kind of statements and all. Similarly, PL SQL has its own way of, okay, its own way of representing all this stuff. PL SQL means programming language in SQL. Okay, so, and this stored procedures belong to PL SQL. Okay, this stored procedure concept belongs to PL SQL. Here in Java, we have functions. Okay. For if you want to repeat the same, okay, if you want to execute some set of code, okay, and multiple times if you want to execute sometime, frequently you are going to use that set of lines of code. Okay, so what you will do, instead of repeatedly writing the same lines of code again and again, you will create the functions. You can call the functions. Whenever you call the function, that particular set of code will be executed. Similar way in PL SQL, the stored procedures are nothing but functions kind of thing in Java. Okay, they are like functions or methods, guys. Their functions are methods. Okay, so stored procedures are like functions or methods in other programming languages. So if you have some code which you need to call repeatedly at later point of times, then you will create a stored procedure, that is function or method for that particular statement which you have to call multiple times. Okay, so stored procedures. And in this video session, I am not going to cover PL SQL. Okay, PL SQL is out of scope for this video session. Okay, video course. So hence I don't want to focus my explanation on stored procedures. Okay, because stored procedures belong to PL SQL and you have to learn the programming, like variables, creating the variables, okay, assigning the literals to this way. This is it's a different world altogether, guys. Okay, I cannot explain all this PL SQL concepts as part of SQL. We can create a separate course on PL SQL if required. Okay, but this is mainly required for developers, guys. If you are a pure developer, okay, if you are not a beginner, and if you just started, you have to start learning with SQL. Later point of time, when you move to a complete development role, and that too, you have a requirement of and that too you have a requirement of programming in PL/SQL, then only you have to learn this PL/SQL. Otherwise, it's not required. And also at same time, if you are a software tester, okay, and to what extent we need to learn? If you are a software tester, you have to learn only SQL. Okay, SQL will be enough base. No need to learn PL/SQL. You are not going to do any programming around SQL. So PL/SQL is not required for software testers also. Mostly they require SQL only. Okay, mostly they will require SQL. Okay, fine. Now, next thing is, I would like to demonstrate, I mean practically demonstrate how to use delimiters with the stored procedures. Okay, that's the main topic, guys. Okay, PL/SQL. Stored procedures are out of topic for this session. Okay, you need to know some small basics about stored procedures. Anyhow, I'll explain that. Okay, they are like functions or methods in other programming languages. If you have a code which need to be repeatedly executed, then what you will do, you will put that code into the function in the programming language. Same thing here also. If you have some SQL statements which are to be called multiple times or repeatedly called, such kind of SQL statements you can put inside a stored procedure, and this stored procedure can be called. We can call this stored procedure, guys, okay, at later point of time. So in this video session, I am going to practically demonstrate how to use delimiters with stored procedures and what is the requirement of using the delimiters with stored procedures. That is the main topic, okay, not stored procedures. Fine. Here we have the QFox database, which is by default selected. That's fine. But yeah, I would like to work on this world database base. Okay, there are four databases here, as you can see here, QFox, Agilasys, and world. So this is created by me in one of the previous videos, but coming to Agilasys and world, okay, this came by default with the MySQL. So which came by default with the MySQL, world is also came by default with the MySQL. I would like to use this world, okay, world DB. How to use that, how to select that, how to say use world, then run this, then world DB will be selected. World DB will be selected. After selecting this world DB, okay, then I can perform any operations on any tables here. Okay, what are the tables that are existing in the world database? Okay, I can perform, after selecting the world database, I can do any operations on the tables which are under the DB. That's fine. Now next thing is, have to show you the requirement for using the delimiters with the stored procedures. Let me start writing a stored procedure now. Okay, so before starting writing a stored procedure, which statement I am going to use is city table. Okay, I would like to use a statement like select star from city. Any statement, some sample SQL statement I am taking, that is select star from city. If I run this, all the details like this, okay, from all the columns of the city table will be displayed here, right? This particular thing I would like to keep under the stored procedure. So now let me create a stored procedure. Create. Okay, this is the syntax for creating the stored procedure, guys. You don't have to learn, but let me explain. Create procedure. Okay, create procedure. Procedure name. Let's say a procedure name is like a function, guys. The kind of function, generally how the type of functions will be there. In one of the previous videos, I explained there are different type of functions, built-in functions in MySQL, right? Like max function, minimum function, okay, count function. This is a syntax. This is how the functions will look like. Similarly, stored procedure is also a function. So which is manually created function. We are manually creating it. It's not built in for MySQL. It's whatever the function I'm going to give, this is not there in the MySQL, guys. Okay. So max, min, and count are the built-in function. But coming to create procedure, get all, okay, cities. Like this, I created some user-defined function with my own way. You can give any name here. Okay. So similarly, I give that kind of name. Create procedure, get all cities. Here you have to start the procedure. Okay, this is just the definition, okay, of the function. Create procedure, procedure name, that is function name kind of thing. Then begin, and here I have to say end. Okay, begin and end. Here I will write a statement like select. This statement I will copy paste here. Okay, nothing but. So this is a starting of the function. Begin means starting of the function. End means ending of the function. Okay, inside this function, select star from city is there. Okay, so that's fine. I have to put a semicolon here. There are two ways, right? A semicolon is there, semicolon here. But I'm getting some errors, guys. The problem here is, okay, the problem here is without delimiter, okay, this procedures cannot be created. So I have to create the delimiter. Delimiter, double slash. I'm saying double slash. I'm just, what is that in the previous video I explained about the delimiter, guys. Okay, if not, you can just go back to the previous video and understand why delimiters have to be used. Okay, delimiter a double slash, I'm saying the default delimiter is semicolon guys. I want to replace the default delimiter with this double slash. So in place of the semicolon, I'm going to use double slash. Here, when I said delimiter double slash, here I can give double slash. Okay. Here I can give double slash. At the end of the stored procedure, I'm giving the double slash in place of semicolon. In place of semicolon, I'm giving double slash. Inside the statement, I'm giving the same semicolon, guys. Okay. So here double slash can also be used in place of the semicolon. Okay. So for one of the semicolon, I use double slash. There is a reason, guys. There is a long, big story behind this why we have to use delimiters and all. Okay. If you want to put this, if you want to send this complete code, SQL code to the server directly, okay, to the server directly, and MySQL don't have to interpret each and every line. Okay. Very technical, guys. You don't have to understand that. Okay. If you are creating a stored procedure, in order to avoid the errors, you can simply, in our case, okay, we can simply use delimiter like this. Okay. Delimiter double slash. And in place of one of the semicolon, which is at the end of the procedure, just replace that with a double slash. This will be enough. This is the way to use the delimiter with the stored procedures. Now, if I create this, what will happen? A function that is a stored procedure will be created. So far, you see under this, there are no stored procedures, right? Under this, in under WorldDB, there are no stored procedures. This stored procedures section is empty. After I run this, okay, after I run this, now refresh, you see, get all cities stored procedure got created. It's a function, guys. It's a kind of function. And while creating this function, we need to use this delimiter. Otherwise, if I don't use, what will happen? I'm going to get errors like this. Okay. To resolve these errors, I have to use delimiter. Okay. Here I have to say semicolon here. Okay. But still, the problem is not getting resolved. So it's mandatory to provide the delimiter. That's the reason I'm using delimiter, guys. You don't have to worry too much technical details about why we have to use delimiter here. Fine, delimiter double slash create procedure get all cities begin select star from city end with the delimiter symbol. So this stands for semicolon itself. Okay, this also works like a semicolon. Now this total section will be sent without interpreting the each and every line. Total section will be sent as a function, okay, to the server or whatever it is. Now anyhow, the procedure got created here. Stored procedure got created here and it got displayed under stored procedures of this DB. Fine. Now, how to call it? There's something called call. Okay. Call this function, this stored procedure. This is a stored procedure, guys. Call get all cities stored procedure. Okay. So, instead of running this SQL statement every time, you can simply call this get all cities automatically inside this select star from city will be running. Okay. Run this. You see? Whatever the result you got with select star from city, when you call this stored function, the same thing will get executed. No matter how many times you run, the same set of SQL statements which are there inside this stored procedure will be executed. You can write any number of lines of code. This in general, if you go with the PL/SQL, right? Okay, you have lot of other keywords coming. PL/SQL. This not declare is not belong to SQL, guys. It's a PL/SQL programming language. Declare. Any variable name you can give, like country, data type you have to specify. Okay, like this, lot of things are there. You can create a while loop and all those stuff. Okay, so in between the begin and end, you can write any number of statements inside this stored procedures, and this call function will simply call this function. Okay, there's a lot of things that you can learn about stored procedures, guys. But I'm not explaining because stored procedures belong to PL/SQL language, not SQL. Okay, they belong to PL/SQL. It's a programming language. You can pass some value to this particular stored procedure function. Okay, or you can get some value in return while executing this function. Everything is there. Whatever that you can get out of a function in Java programming, that you can get with the stored procedures. But this is out of topic for us, guys. PL/SQL is not in our video course, so I'm not covering it. And it's only required for the pure developers who have the requirement of writing the programming using SQL statements. Okay, for them only it is required. For remaining people, you don't have to learn. SQL will be fine enough. Okay, you don't have to worry about that. So guys, this is all about how to use delimiters. Okay, while creating the stored procedures, here I explained how to use delimiter while creating the stored procedure. While creating the stored procedure, I need delimiters, right? Here, delimiter double slash, how to use it. Okay, this is the way of using it, guys. Okay, fine, guys. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.